Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I am Kedar, and on this channel we talk about design, architecture, parametric design and generative AI. And in today's video I wanted to test, does having more GPU power gives you better images? And for this test I wanted to use three scenarios. The first one is using a 3060 6GB VRAM laptop. The second one is going to be a 4090 16GB VRAM laptop, and the third one is going to be a cloud interface, for which I will be using Comfy Cloud that released recently. And you might be wondering, why am I doing this test now? So last week I was doing a workshop in collaboration with Futurely called ComfyUI for Architects, where the participants were using different range of GPUs that were giving them range of different outputs. So some were getting really blurry results, while some were getting really nice crisp results. And they were asking me, is this because of the GPU that they have? And even I started wondering, is this actually true? So I wanted to test, does quantization really matter so much with respect to the full version of the models? And if you remember what quantization mean, it looks something like this. So this is a screenshot of WAN 2.2, where as you increase the quantization, or as they increase the quantization, it is going to allow you to work on low-end GPUs, and if the quantization is less, it needs higher GPU. For instance, you have this Q2 and Q3, the file size will be less, but the quality also will be reduced, whereas when you have something like Q6 and Q8, the file size will be higher and the quality also will be higher. So this is basically how quantization works. I will link my WAN 2.2 video here, which talks in detail about how quantization works. But for this video, I wanted to test four models, which is going to be Flux.1 Dev, Qwen Image, HiDream and WAN 2.2. And you might be wondering why these four specific models. So I went to the artificial analysis website, I clicked on the open weights, and the top five models even today are going to be Flux.1 Dev, Qwen Image, HiDream Dev and Fast. I selected only the Dev, but instead of Hunyuan Image 2.1, I selected WAN 2.2, which is currently my favorite image generation model. And that's how I selected those four models, which is going to be again HiDream, Qwen Image, Flux.1 Dev and WAN 2.2. Now let's look at the testing process that I have followed, because I wanted to have consistency across the images. So for this, the first one is going to be the GUF model, like I told you. It's going to be for a 4090 16GB VRAM laptop and a 3060 6GB VRAM laptop. And then I'm going to use Comfy Cloud for the cloud version, which released recently. So I got this mail on October 14 from ComfyUI team that I now have access to the beta version. If you also want to have access to the beta version, you can simply go to this website comfy.org/cloud and click on join the waitlist. You need to add some of your details, wait for a few days, and then you will get a similar confirmation email. Once you get that, simply click on that email and then you can say accept invite. And once you accept the invite, you will be gone to the Comfy Cloud. It looks absolutely similar to the ComfyUI app. The only thing, you don't have manager right now, which means you don't have access to all the custom nodes, but you have all the base workflows and all the base models available. I went through the Comfy Cloud FAQ and I found out that the private beta is completely free. So if you were skeptical about learning ComfyUI or not, this is going to be one of the great options. And right now, the maximum entries is going to be 256, which in my opinion is really fine. So if you were wondering whether you want to learn ComfyUI, this is a really good option. They are not paying me, this video is not sponsored, but it is important that I put it out there. So then I went to Comfy Cloud, then I went to Flux, then I selected the Flux Dev version, and I get this workflow. Okay, and simply all we need to do is press run and you get the image. So again, this has a limitation of entries of 256, but you can test it out. Apart from that, I also wanted to keep certain things consistent in the workflow. So yes, we have these four models and I will be using the same base workflows. I will not add IP adapter or control net or anything like that. The aspect ratio will be 4:5 and the seed is going to be 100, so that we get similar images and it's easy for us to compare. And the prompts are going to be these four, which I've tested earlier. One is going to be a parametric building, a napping ginger cat, miniature origami landscape, and an exploded thali. Okay, so this is the setting that I have kept consistent for all of these tests. And the slide will look something like this. So on the top, the entire full prompt will be listed for you. The first image is going to be from a 3060 6GB VRAM laptop. The middle one is going to be from a RTX 4090 16GB VRAM laptop. And the last one is going to be from ComfyUI Cloud. Below that, I'm going to specify what is the model size in GB, the image resolution and the number of steps I've taken. And with this detailed setup, now let's see the difference in the images from the quantized version versus the full version of the models. So the first one is going to be Flux.1 Dev. and this is the base workflow that I'm using. For the cloud one, I only swapped this for load diffusion model, and that's about it. So this is the workflow for Flux.1 Dev. And the quantized model that I'll be using is going to be a Q2K, which is around 4 GB, and a Q6K that is around 9.6 GB. Okay, now let's see the results. And for the first prompt, which is the parametric building, you do see that as the quantization increases, the noisiness and blurriness really increases. But what was interesting for me to know that the 9 GB and the 22 GB model gave almost similar result, not just in terms of the composition, but in terms of the image quality as well. That was really interesting to note. Let me zoom in so you see more of the blurriness. So in the first one, you see the Q2K model, it is really blurry and noisy. Even if you will upscale it, it is not going to be useful at all. But the 9 GB and the 22 GB model look almost really the same. So it kind of made me wonder that does quantization depend on the model, how they are quantized, and not really the GPU that we have. Let's see some of the other results. Now for this napping ginger cat, again the same thing follows. The Q2K is really blurry, while the 9 GB and 22 GB model look really same. Let me zoom in again, and you will see for the first one, it is really noisy. This doesn't even look like this cat has fur. It just looks like a random brush strokes. Whereas for the 9 GB and 22 GB model, the fur looks really nice, and once you will upscale it, it looks really, really good. So for Flux, the quantization does affect as you go further down the line, but not for the higher quantization. Okay, the similar trend follows for this Origami Miniature Landscape City. Again, in this Q2K model, this does not look like origami at all. It just looks like some paper has been cut and then pasted on these trees. Whereas with this Q6K and the full version, you see it's more of an origami landscape. Okay, so the same trend kind of follows for Flux. Even with Exploded Thali, the first one is really, really blurry. I can't even upscale this. The second and the third one is really good. So the conclusion personally for me from Flux was that yes, the quantization does affect, but if you're using the higher quantized version, you're going to get similar result as the base model. And now let's see the output from Qwen Image. And I will be using this particular workflow. With Qwen Image, you do have a distilled LoRa, so that's why the step count can go to 4. But one problem with Qwen was there was no model of 6 GB. So you see, when I select RTX 3060 6 GB VRAM, none of these are usable. So instead of that, I've downloaded two GUF model, a Q2K and a Q3KM, one of 7 GB and one of around 10 GB. And I'm using both of these on my 4090 laptop. Now let's see the results. So the first one, again, in this case, is this parametric building. Now, similarly, how with Flux, you had the quantization affect the quality, even with Qwen, the quantization does affect the quality. But what is interesting to note, whereas in Flux, the 9 GB and 22 GB were giving you the same result, here in this case, the 19 and 9 GB, there is a difference. And there is also a difference between the 9 GB and 7 GB. So there is a consistent quality drop in the quantization for Qwen Image. And if I zoom in, you will clearly notice how the building looks blurry in the first image. The second one looks better, and the third one, it looks really better. So for Qwen, the quantization is going to be constant throughout. It is not as bad as the Flux Dev one. Now let's see for the napping cat example. And here I really like all of these three results. Even the most quantized version looks so good. Yes, the fur does look like brushstroke. Let me zoom in. So you will see the fur does look like brushstroke. But you see the depth of field is really nicely captured in all of these three images. So really, with quantization in Qwen, it does affect, but not so much as Flux.1 Dev. Now if I go to the Origami Landscape City, again, of course, the quantization does affect. One of the interesting things that I noticed for this miniature origami landscape is look at the birds. The first one, they almost look like they are birds. The second one is a hybrid of origami and bird. The third one is literally an origami bird. So here, clearly, the quantization does affect for Qwen Image. Again, like I said, not so much as Flux. Okay. Now for Exploded Thali, these are so good results from Qwen. I just feel hungry seeing this. But again, the same trend follows. The quantization does affect, but not so much. For, like I said, again, I'm going to be repeating myself. The Flux one, the base model was not usable. With Qwen, even the base model is usable. Okay. Now let's look at HiDream, where the quantization really matters a lot. So this is a workflow that I'm using for HiDream. It's going to be a simple workflow. And for the quantized model for HiDream, I'm going to use a Q2K that is around 6.57 GB and a Q4KM that is around 11.5 GB. Okay. And let's see the results. And this is really surprising. You see this? The quantization affects so much for HiDream that Q2 model is unusable. Okay. I'm going to zoom in quickly. And you will see it is not usable at all. Even if I upscale this Q2 model, it is going to give you pathetic upscale. So if you are a person working with HiDream, you do need a laptop or a computer with higher VRAM, because you see clearly here with the 15 GB model, it is good. With 11 GB, there is more blurriness and the Q2 6 GB model is unusable at all. Let me go to the cat example now, and the same kind of logic follows here. The first one is absolutely unusable. You see the purple tone near the cat's nose, the ears, and even if you upscale it, it is going to be the same because color will not change. So again, if you're using HiDream, you need the best GPU. And if I zoom in again, you will see how blurry the output from Q2 is. The Q4 is respectable and the developer version model is really nice. See the fur, how amazing it looks. So again, if you're using HiDream, you need the highest GPU available for you. Then again, the same kind of trend is going to be followed for this origami miniature city. In this case, this first one is unusable. The second one I can upscale. The third one as it is good. And for the exploded thali, the same thing. The first one, not usable. Second one also in this case is really not usable. Doesn't really look nice and appetizing. The third one is usable and I can upscale it. So with HiDream, the quantization does affect a lot. Clearly, we are seeing a pattern here. It is not about the GPU. It is about the model that you're using, okay? And the last test is going to be of VAN 2.2 image generation. And this is the workflow that I'm using. So for VAN 2.2, when you want to convert text to image, you don't need to use both the high noise and the low noise. You only need to use the low noise model along with the digital LoRa so you can reduce the step count. But in this case, I'm going to keep the steps as 20 so I get really nice results, okay? And the quantized version that I'm using is going to be a Q2K, which is a 5 GB model, and a Q5KM, which is going to be a 10 GB model. I have downloaded so many models to test this. It was really crazy. And now let's see the output. For VAN, surprisingly, the quantization does not affect so much. So even when you have the full version, that is 26 GB versus 10 GB versus a 5 GB, all of these outputs are really usable. Let me zoom in. And you see, they all are usable. You can upscale it. So if you are using VAN 2.2 for image generation, it is okay even if you have a lower GPU. Let's see for the cat result now. Again, the same trend follows and I absolutely love VAN 2.2. I think you should test this model for image generation. You will be blown away. And let me zoom into this and you see how nice all of these outputs are. Yes, the first one, when I zoom in, these again fur look like brush strokes. So the quantization, of course, it will affect. The second one looks really nice. The third one has to be my favorite. I love how the calmness is being expressed by the cat. And look at this shadow near the edge of his ear and the fur. Looks so nice and detailed. So definitely VAN has an advantage for image generation and the quantization does affect, but not so much. Now for the miniature origami landscape, here again the same thing kind of follows. I don't know why in the first one, the car is out on the grass and the people on the road, maybe the car is parked, who knows. But again, the quantization does affect, but not so much. Even if you upscale all of these three, nobody's going to notice whether you have used the quantized version or the developer version. Now the last one, exploded thali, again, absolutely love the results. The same thing follows. I don't know what else to say about it. The quantization affects, but not so much. If I would upscale, you would not even know from which model I have taken these outputs. Okay, so let's compare all of those models' output now. So for the first parametric building, clearly here you can see how bad the result from HiDream and Flux.1 Dev is. The rest are usable. I can upscale it. If I had to choose, two of my favorite outputs in this case are going to be these one. The VAN output, because it is so nice, crisp and clear, but it did not do a building. It's more of a pavilion. And I chose the Qwen one because of the seam lines that it is added. It is really nice. If you know, when you work with doubly or singly curved surfaces, there is going to be a seam line that connects two of the panels, which is nicely executed by the Qwen model, and none of the other models have done that. So clearly, if I have to only talk about the quantization, HiDream and Flux are really affected by it. Qwen and Van are not affected so much. Let's see a lot of cats now. So these are around 12 cats. Love all of them. Again, in this case, the same kind of logic follows. The HiDream, the first model, is not usable. The Flux Dev is usable, but is going to look like brushstrokes. In this case, my favorite output is this one. The Van 2.2, the full version, really did a great job. It could be real, you know, this could be a photograph in itself. Rest of them do have that AI aesthetic to it. This one did not have it. So this is my favorite output. And then let's compare the images of miniature origami landscape. Again, the same logic will follow for HiDream and Flux. Don't want to repeat over and over. But you can also comment down which output did you really like from which model, what quantization configuration. Would love to know from you as well. For this one, my personal favorite is going to be this Qwen output. Really love how everything kind of follows the same style. And for the last one, Exploded Thali, these are so good as a result. Again, you can let me know which one you like. My personal favorite is again going to be this Qwen output from the full version. I do love the smoke that is coming here, which none of the other models have done. Yes, HiDream has put a little bit here, but Qwen, even with the most quantized version, has put this smoke effect, which makes it so appetizing, and I absolutely love it. Okay, so what is the conclusion of these 48 images? So the conclusion is very simple. Yes, more GPU means better images at first go, but it's not the only criteria. It also depends on the model. If you use a Van 2.2 or Qwen, the quantization will not affect so much. So if you're using a 3060, it really works. But if you're using something like Flux.1 Dev or HiDream, you're going to really feel like I need to upgrade my GPU. So it does not depend on the GPU, but depend on the model, which was really interesting for me to find out, because even I was skeptical, do I need to update my laptop to get the best results? But that is not the case. Please don't fall for the trap that you need the best GPU to get good AI images. It is not true. It depends on the model that you're using. Okay. And this is only for image generation. For video generation, simple answer, the more GPU, the better output. Because with images, we can upscale, we can inpaint, we can tweak the images. But for video generation, we don't have that much flexibility yet. So the question that I started, does high-end GPU give you better image quality? The simple answer is yes, but the detailed answer, it does not depend on GPU, it depends on the model. And I think that's it. This was really an interesting experiment for me personally, because I was always like, no, you need to have better GPU to get better results, but it's not true. It all depends on the models. So I hope you liked my small comparison of these four models for the quantized and the full version. If there is any other model you want me to test, please comment it and I can do that as well. Thank you for your time. Please do everything that YouTube suggests, that is like, share, subscribe, hype. And don't fall for the idea that better GPU gives you better images. Select a better model and I will see you in the next one. Thank you.